In 2023, a new species of spider was discovered and subsequently named Hot Wheel Sisyphus. I've seen some people talk about the funny name of this spider, but I haven't seen anyone dive into the deep lore of why it has a name like that, so I'm gonna do that here, because this is my channel and I do what I want here. I will say that this video will have pictures of spiders as well as pictures of spider genitalia, so if you don't want to see that, then you're probably going to want to avoid watching this video. I am sourcing all my information from the paper that announces the discovery of Hot Wheel Sisyphus, and from stuff that I know because I read the Journal of Arachnology for fun in my free time. I'll leave some reading in the description if anyone's interested in the topic, though. The Hot Wheel Sisyphus is named after its genitalia. The people who named the species reason that the looping of the male embolus reminds them of a Hot Wheels track, and the cyclic looping of the female copulatory ducts reminded them of the Greek legend Sisyphus, who's trapped in a cycle of rolling a rock up a hill. I'm sure it had nothing to do with the meme, but why? Why do they look like that? Why does this spider species have such weird genitalia, you might be thinking? Also, what's an embolus? To answer that question, we must return way back in history, to the time when life was first moving on land. Up to this point, species had been reproducing in water, which is super convenient because you can simply yeet out the sperm and the eggs and have them mixed together right there in the water. Going on land presented problems because if you try to do the same thing on land, then the eggs and the sperm dry out and die. So lots of species would still go back to have babies in the water. Some species evolved alternative solutions, such as the penis. With this brand new technology, you can transfer sperm inside a female so that the egg cells get fertilized there and won't dry out and die on the ground. And then you can either form a shell or a membrane over that to form an egg that is capable of surviving on land, or you can just finish the development internally and give live birth. Baby is developed enough to not dry out and die. Cool. But spiders didn't do this because they're a bit special. If you're old like me, you might recall the iconic Yahoo Answers question, "Does spider have puss-puss?" The answer to that question is yes. Actually, spider females have multiple puss-puss. Female spiders have two openings for mating. Usually when I relay the information of the double spideracy to people, which is often, their next question is, so do spider males have two penises then? And the answer is no. In fact, spider males don't even have one penises. They have zero penises. Instead, they have what I'll be calling by its scientific name of the spider male gonopore. Spiders just kinda weren't vibing with that whole penis thing, I suppose. At least, most species weren't. Actually, you can apply the notion of most of the time to everything I say, because there's lots of spider species, and they're very diverse, and there are probably exceptions to everything. Okay, so then if spiders generally don't have penises, then how do they internally fertilize the female's egg cells, you might be asking? Well, the first thing you need to understand is that spider sperm survives for a long time. Like, months. Or even years. Much cooler than human sperm, which won't even live for a week. So spider sperm does not need to be used right away. It can be stored. And spider males have an organ just for that, attached to their pedipalps, which are these cool thingies here, is the genital bulb. Also known as the palpal bulb, but I'm having trouble pronouncing that word, so I won't be calling it that. The spider male uses this to slurp up its own semen and then keep it safe until a suitable female comes along. Then the males can use this long tube thingy here, which is called an embolus, to transfer their stale semen into the female. Now you might be thinking, oh, so that's why the spider females have two vaginas? It's because the spider males have two pedipalps, but you'd be wrong. The males still only use one bulb to mate. The double spiders is actually solely for the female's benefit. You see, the spider females are a bit picky about their baby daddies. Like, imagine you mate with someone, and then you find out that they were actually kinda cringe, or you find a better male, but now you're already carrying the cringe male's cringe babies. To avoid situations like that, the female genitalia has an interesting property of being able to spit. We have established that spider sperm can survive for a very long time. So technically, there is no reason that the spider female couldn't just have the sperm hang out in her vagina, and if she meets a better male, she can mate with that one using the other vagina and then yeet out the unworthy sperm from the other male. So the female spider has these little pouches called spermateca, the function of which is just that. They can store and remove and transfer sperm. This way, the spider female also doesn't have to use the sperm unless she deems that the time is right for making eggs. She can either keep it in there waiting for better days, or she can just yeet it away. She may even only use some of the sperm and then keep the rest in there for when she wants to bear another clutch. This is beneficial for the female because she can choose to only have the healthiest babies in the safest situations, which contributes to both her and the baby's survival. But it kind of sucks for the cringe males whose sperm is getting yeeted out for being unworthy. So while the spider females evolved the spitting double spideracy, the males of some species evolved a countermeasure of making their embolus so long that it bypasses the spermateca and instead fertilizes the egg cells right away, kind of like in humans and other mammals. This provides a reproductive advantage for the male, but it sucks for the female, so in turn the females end up evolving longer copulatory ducts to counteract the male's countermeasure, so now the males can't reach past the spermateca anymore. And in turn, the males end up evolving an even longer embolus, and the females end up evolving an even longer duct, and this is how we get spiders like the Hot Wheels Sisyphus. The Hot Wheels track here is evidence of an evolutionary battle over reproductive rights. The cyclical nature of the embolus and copulatory duct, as well as the cycle of males and females trying to outpace each other in evolution, makes the name Sisyphus very appropriate. Or at least that is one of the theories for the evolutionary reasons behind this phenomenon of elongated emboli and reproductive ducts. Researching the mechanisms of evolution is difficult at best, and there's always some amount of guesswork involved. It is known that male spiders with longer emboli tend to have better reproductive success, and that it is specifically the copulatory duct leading up to the spermateca that gets longer in females, while fertilization ducts leading from the spermateca to the uterus remain short. Also, I couldn't find any other explanation for the phenomenon while fact-checking this video. Yeah, so anyways, that's the lore. Bye!